today you have a homework to draw the image formation. Okay, so please draw the image formation in your concave mirror. So the homework will be posted this evening. Okay, so that you can easily understand how a mirror reflects. Okay, that is figure number 6.8, page number 70. Okay, textbook. Figure number 6.8, page number 70. That is the homework. First 5 cases. A, B, C, D, and E. Okay. You take a sheet of paper and draw a curved surface using a small pan. Okay. And you can use compass. Okay. Please understand that the rough surface is given with lines. Okay, this is called the rough surface or opaque surface. So this one is the polished surface. This is called a concave mirror. Please remember that. Don't write rays on this side. There won't be any reflection. Okay, that you have to understand. Fine. So today I shall tell you something about the other portions which are left. So one is speed of light. Okay, so we have learned the properties of light, and there is a small history behind the speed of light. We are not going too deep into that speed of light, determination, velocity of light, etc. We will be learning in ninth classes. So there were few scientists. They were working on the light to determine the speed of light. Okay, that we are going to see a small history, and then we are going to see property called refraction of light. So I will show you a demo. You can yourself construct the same demo in your home. Okay, so with your brothers and sisters, you can use their help. Okay, fine. First of all, what is the speed of light? So it is the distance traveled by light in 1 second. So what is the distance traveled by light in 1 second? So we have known the speed of sound. So what is the speed of sound? So it is about 330 to 340 meters per second. A sound wave can travel up to 330 or 340. So that depends upon the temperature. Okay, so when room temperature, normally it is sound wave will be traveling in a speed of 330 to 340 meters per second. So what is the velocity of light? So that was determined by several scientists. Okay, earlier, so Galileo Galilei. Okay, so Galileo Galilei, he was the first scientist. So who tried to calculate the speed of, okay, Galileo Galilei was the first one who tried to calculate the speed of light. Okay, so in 17th century. So after that, Ole Rømer. Okay, so experimentally, so Galileo Galilei and Ole Rømer, they were using their telescopes. Okay, they were using their telescopes. You know that Galileo Galilei was constructing a telescope. So why did he construct a telescope? In order to view the celestial objects. Okay, so and they were trying to calculate. So Ole Rømer, he developed an instrument and he calculated sound and velocity of light as 220,000 kilometers per second. Okay, so Ole Rømer, so he was a Dutch scientist. He was trying to calculate the speed or the velocity of light as 220,000 kilometers per second. Okay, he used the light rays reflected from the 12 moons of Jupiter. So what do you mean by a moon? Moon is a natural satellite of any planet. So moon is not only the moon we are seeing from Earth. So moon is nothing but a natural satellite. Natural satellite. So that is revolving around a particular planet. We have only one moon. Jupiter has 12 moons. He sends some light to the he just received the light from that moons of Jupiter, okay, and he calculated the experimental demonstration was not there, but he can calculate the speed of sound, the speed of light as 220,000 kilometer per second. Light travels in the speed of 220,000 kilometer per second. So after Ole Rømer, Fizeau, okay, so Hermann Fizeau, F-I-Z-E-A-U, so Fizeau. So this is very important. So Fizeau was the first person. Fizeau, F-I-Z-E-A-U, Fizeau. So Hermann Fizeau, he was the first scientist to construct or to develop the instruments, etc., to determine the velocity of light. So Hermann Fizeau. So Fizeau's experiment. Okay, fine. So he was able to calculate as 3 lakh kilometer per second as the speed of light. So which is exactly same as now you have the calculations. Okay. So approximately 2.9 meter per second. So 2.9 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second, or you can write 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. Okay, so these are simple calculations, and what you have to remember is there is a small history behind the determination of velocity of light. So that was started by Galileo and Hermann. Okay, so Hermann Fizeau was the first one to calculate the speed of light as 3 lakh kilometer per second, or 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. Is it clear? So this is small history. Okay. Okay. So now let us see what is refraction. What is refraction of light? So we are learning about the properties of light. Okay, so refraction of light. So today I have a small experiment. Okay, first of all, please try to understand what is refraction. So you have a light ray. You have a light ray, and the light, as the property is to travel along a straight line. Okay. There is a light ray, there is a source. This is the source. Light ray is coming from the source. Suppose there is air, okay, so there is only air, no other medium. The light ray travels in a straight line. Okay, so without any disturbance or hurdle, light can travel through a straight line. Okay, so this is the property of light. Now what happens? I am going to put some obstacle. Okay, I am going to put a glass. So assume that this is a transparent glass. Okay, it is a glass. Now I am going to put a glass on the path of light. Now what happens? Just you have seen that. Many signboards like this. Have you seen this? Take diversion. Okay, so men are at work, take diversion. Have you seen this? So you are going to a particular destination. At some point you can see this. So you might be thinking that the path is straight there, but there is some diversion. Okay, so adutha paadhil sellavum maatru paadhil sellavum, like that. It's okay. So take diversion. So you change your path. So the moment you look at the signboard, what do you do? You just change. So you are going straight, take diversion, divert, and then go. This is what is exactly happening in refraction. There is a light ray, and as far as the light ray is traveling in air or vacuum, there is no change in its path. okay, right ray travels straight. So okay, in air. This is the property. Now there is an obstacle. Say for example, a glass. Okay, there is a glass. Now at this junction, you have a. So at this point, I have some glass slab. Okay, assume that this is a glass slab. At this junction, what happens is that the light ray is changing. Okay, suppose I take some oblique light. Okay, so this is called oblique. So first one is a straight or perpendicular. Light is falling on the perpendicularly on the glass plate. Now I take the oblique light. I have the source here. So this is the light source. Okay, so light source travels through the air. So here you have the air. So this is what? This is glass. Okay, this is glass. Okay, fine. So the light ray falls on the glass. What will happen if there is no glass? If there is no glass, what will happen? Light has to travel through this light, isn't it? Okay, it has to travel like this. So without glass, as we have some glass as an obstacle, the light ray changes its path. How does it change? Okay, how does it change? Take diversion. Whether we have to go to left or right, that has to be determined. There is only one way in the street. That is the option. Only one option. But in case of light ray, it has two options. So light ray travels in a straight line. When there is an obstacle like glass, it has to take a different path. It has two choices. It has two choices. One, it can go left or it can go right. So we don't say left or right. We have a definition for that. What we have to do is we have to draw a normal at the point of incidence. So this is the point of incidence. Okay, this is the point of incidence. You draw a perpendicular line to the surface of the glass. Okay, you have drawn a perpendicular line. This is called a normal. N is called what? Normal. Normal is nothing but the perpendicular line drawn at the point of incidence. Okay, so this is glass. This is air. Air, glass, then air. Okay, you have air. And then glass and then air. So now to determine the path of the light, you have to draw a normal. Okay? And what happens is that when this light travels from air to glass, the light ray turns towards the normal. So this is the actual path. But it does not traverse that path, it turns, okay? So I can show like this, okay? So light travels in the air, comes here, touches the interface between air and glass, and turns it path. Are you able to understand? Light ray turns it path, turns towards the normal. Are you able to understand? So if you have understood this, the refraction will be clear. If you don't understand, there will be problem in understanding further concepts in your higher classes. Is it clear? What will happen if there is a glass, a different medium, light changes its path. No different medium. It will travel in a straight line. Okay? So light ray comes in air and reaches the glass. You have a normal. You have a normal at the point of incidence. After refraction, what happens? Light ray changes its path, but it moves towards the normal. See the angle I am getting? Towards the normal. So this is normal. Light ray travels or changes its direction towards the normal and reaches here. Okay, so once it has entered into a glass medium, it has to come out of that medium to have another point in this glass. So this is another point. You can also draw a normal at this point. Okay, again you can draw a normal, that is a perpendicular line. Now what happens? Light ray presently traveling inside glass, now it has to come out. It has to come, so it has to go like this. Okay, this is the path. So within glass, suppose you have extended glass, it has to go like this. But at this junction, it meets again air. At this junction, it meets again air. That means a rarer medium. Okay, Kritika, I will come to your question. It can happen in water also. I am going to show you a small demo now using water. Okay. So light ray, so please understand, light ray falls obliquely on a glass plate. At the point of incidence, it changes its path. How does it change its path? It travels towards the normal. It travels towards the normal. What is normal? Normal is an imaginary perpendicular line drawn at the point of incidence. Okay, inside glass it travels like this. Again, it meets air at this point. It has to exit the glass medium. Again, if you draw the normal, now the light will move away from the normal. Okay, so incident light changes its direction towards the normal. At the exit, it moves, okay, away from the normal. So understood? Yeah, glass. When the light ray enters glass or water, it moves towards the normal, and when it leaves the glass medium, it moves away from the normal. Therefore, light ray turns towards normal, turns away from normal. Okay, so I will draw it again. Please understand this. So this is a glass slab. Okay, this is a glass slab. So light ray travels through air. This is the point of incidence. I have a normal. At this junction, it moves towards the normal. Okay, light ray towards the normal. It travels up to this. At this junction, again I have some normal. Here it moves away from the normal. Okay. At this point, towards normal, when it exits glass, away from the normal. Therefore, so it will be seeming that, okay, so light ray is coming here, changes, again changes, okay. So this will just appear that the light ray is coming from here. Suppose you extend this. So after refraction, suppose you extend this line. So suppose you observe from here, what will happen? The light ray will appear from coming here. Actually, the light ray is coming from where? Suppose the point is A, this point is B. Light ray or the source is at B. Light ray is coming from source B. Okay? It enters glass, turn towards normal, it travels in glass, comes out of glass, it moves away from the normal. But suppose we observe from this side, it will look like the light ray is coming from some point A. Okay, so this is called a change in direction of light. Okay, change in the direction of light. So why does it happen? Because of the nature of the medium. Because of what? Nature of the medium. So what nature? Optical nature. Optical nature, the concept is optical density. Okay, for air optical density is less, for glass optical density is more, for water optical density is more than air. Okay, therefore the speed of light changes in different medium. So because of the change in speed, it has changed its direction. Okay, this is called refraction. This is called refraction. Okay, now I shall give you a small example, a demo. So is the concept clear? The concept is change in direction of the light ray is called refraction. It depends upon the nature of the medium. An important point is that at the point of incidence from rarer medium, that is air, when the light ray travels from rarer medium to denser medium, the ray bends towards normal. The same light ray, when it travels from denser medium to rarer medium, it bends away from the normal. Please remember this. Air to glass, light ray bends towards normal. Okay, glass to air or water to air, the ray bends away from the normal. Okay, is it understood? Any doubt in this? Okay, now I shall show you a small demo. Okay, so I have a glass tumbler. So here I have a beaker. So you can try this. Okay, you can try this in your home. Please ask your mother or father or your brother or sister to help you. Okay, so you take a glass tumbler, not glass, ever silver tumbler you can take. Okay, so here I don't have any ever silver tumbler. I just took a beaker. Okay, so it should be opaque. Okay, so it has to be covered. So I will just cover it. So to show you, I will just use this glass. Otherwise, I will cover this. Okay, you take a glass tumbler. Okay. And what you have to do is, you can just put a coin. Okay, you just put a coin. You take some coin, 5 rupee coin or then 1 rupee coin. Okay, like this. Okay, you can put a coin. Are you able to see the coin? Yes. Okay. You just put some coin at the center, okay? Coin at the center. Now, please ask your brother or sister or father or mother, anyone. Okay, so now it should be opaque. So all sides are covered. Okay, so it should be opaque. Okay, fine. Now, through this opening, okay, so through this opening, ask them to see that whether you are able to see that coin. You just hold it. Then ask them to come closer. So you have, they have to look at the beaker. So they should not be able to view the coin. Okay, up to a particular distance. This is trial and error. Okay, just hold it. Ask them to see whether they are able to see the coin. Okay, so you, the limit should be just few millimeters after the coin's location. Okay, so if they look at here, so they have to look at here, so they will be looking here, but they should not be able to, so they can up look at here. So this is the coin. Okay, so ask them to see the coin. There is no coin. Okay, they will say that there is no coin. Now what you have to do is, you just pour some amount of water. And fill half of the glass with water. Okay, just hold like this. So just ask them to look like this. There is no coin, or they are not able to view the coin. And if you pour some water, okay, so they will be able to see. So when you have some water, when you pour some water, ask them to stand at the same position. They will be able to see some coin here. Okay, so this is the small experiment. Actually, the coin is at the center. You have to put it on the center. So without water, suppose you pour more amount of water, okay, you can see. So the you can see that the coin will be moving like this. Okay, you have to pour more amount of water. You can see easily the coin moving. Actually, it is not moving. Now they are sitting at the same position, but this coin appears to be here. Okay, suppose they have a stick and they want to touch the coin. At this point, they can't touch because the coin is at the center, but the coin appears to be moved. Okay, so how does this happen? Okay, the same principle, refraction. Okay, so you can take the junction here. Okay, so it's like a junction. So there is a light ray. So I will redraw this. Just 2 minutes. So I will complete this. Okay, so you have glass tumbler. You have coin here. Okay. Fine. So we have some water inside. Now what happens? Light ray. Suppose somebody is observing from here. Okay, somebody is observing from. I am looking this here. So I look through this here. Okay, so through this opening, I am looking at eye. Fine. Now the light ray is coming. Kritika, yes, it will happen only in pure water. Suppose it is the water is opaque. You can't see. Okay, the light ray is coming from this coin towards the eye. Okay, because I am looking here. Okay, so this is the path of the light ray. Okay, so light ray means the reflected light. The coin, the light has reflected from the coin. Okay, now it travels like this. So what is this? So until this height, you have water. Here you have air. Here you have air. Therefore, at this junction, if you draw a normal, at this junction, if you imagine a normal, what is the rule? When a light ray travels from a denser medium to rarer medium, it will move away from the normal. Okay, so this is the actual part. This should be the actual part, but this is water. This is air. It touches the surface, that is interface. It moves away. It means, so from this normal, the light ray bends away from the normal. So this is towards the normal. This is away from the normal. Towards, away. Towards, away. Okay. At this point, the light ray is changing its direction and moves away. Okay, like that. So it will be changing its direction. Okay. Suppose if we extend this. If you extend this imaginary line, so the coin will be appearing here. Okay, they can see. It seems that okay. It seems that the coin is at the corner. Suppose you put the coin at the center, they will be looking at the coin which is at the corner. So without moving the coin, they can see the coin only when the water is up to a particular level. If you pour more amount of water, they can see more amount of coin. That is the dimension of the coin will be increasing. Okay, so up to the end, you have to fill up the water to see the full coin. Okay, suppose half of it, you can see only half of the coin. Okay, are you able to understand? Light ray travels from the coin towards the observer. Okay, first time they are not able to see anything, and now they can see that the light ray is changing its direction. Okay, so without this water air interface, it can travel like this. As there is water, it has to change its path. That is, it is moving away from the path. Okay, so this is a small instrument. Please try this